Hi, Australia. It's Billie. Let's go.
There is no bigger name in music right now than
Billie.
At just 14 years old, Billie Eilish became a true overnight sensation when a song she made in her brother's bedroom propelled her to global superstardom. It was the beginning of a whirlwind few years that would see her go on to become the biggest pop star on the planet.
Billie Eilish.
Billie Eilish.
So you're a tough guy, like you're really rough guy, just can't get enough guy, just always so tough guy.
With her debut album smashing records, landing 8 Grammys, and racking up more than 15 billion streams.
What? Oh my God.
I'm your bad guy.
Duh.
Billie Eilish, welcome to the project.
Thanks for having me. I'm very pleased to be here. How are you?
I'm really well and great to be chatting with you. Congratulations on the new album. It's almost here. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling excited and scared and nervous and hopeful and all a lot of things. I'm feeling a lot of things.
So you still get nervous ahead of a new release?
Yeah, I mean, especially just because this is my second album and there's like almost more pressure for this one than the last one, just because it was, you know, the first time I'd done it. I didn't know what I was doing. Nobody really cared about it. I hadn't done it before. Just like so many differences. And then this one is just like, I don't know. I feel like there's such higher standards almost and like expectations. So I'm just feeling things and it's okay. I'm excited mostly and, you know, it is what it is.
Happier Than Ever follows the extraordinary success of Billie's first album, and since its release on Friday, the album has already received critical acclaim, cementing her as one of our most significant pop artists.
How would you say your music has evolved since the first album, Billie?
A lot. It's mainly like a big age difference. I was 16, 15 making that album, and just my creative process was so different and my voice has changed so much and matured and gotten better and gotten stronger. And in the making of Happier Than Ever, I felt like I could feel myself getting better.
You were nothing but a lost cause, and this ain't nothing like it once was. I know you think it's such an outlaw, but you got no job.
Two of the songs from the album that I love, Your Power and Lost Cause, seem to be about taking control back from a negative relationship, which is a brilliant message to be putting out there. Is that a bit of a theme in this album?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, making the album was a period of time where I was just doing a lot of like self-reflecting, and it was like the first time I had a moment to actually think through and process a lot of things I've been through in my life that I haven't even had time to think about. And now that I'm kind of past them, it's easier to think about things that you go through, and then you realize what they were like and you're like, what? Like, I don't know.
This all started for you when you and your brother Phineas uploaded Ocean Eyes to SoundCloud and it just went gangbusters overnight. Can you take me through what that night was like for you?
So the moment that I knew that people were listening to that song was I was in Starbucks and I was 13. I was drinking whatever I was drinking, hot chocolate or something, and my brother called me and he was like, dude, our song has 1,000 plays. And of course, 1,000 to me was like 30 million. And that was like how it felt. I thought it was just gonna be that moment and that would be it, you know? But that was wrong.
Very wrong. In fact, the last few years have been stacked with those moments, one of which was writing a James Bond theme song, joining the ranks of Paul McCartney, Carly Simon, and Adele.
Pressure.
No, right? I mean, it's how you would think. It was so surreal and crazy. Also, because for years and years, Phineas and I would constantly talk about how cool it would be to make a Bond song. Like, it was like a reoccurring conversation that we would have all the time. It had been such a thought about fantasy for like literally years. So, you know, it was insane. It was insane. I'm not your friend.
Experience of growing up is about experimenting and making mistakes, but you've been famous since you first became a teenager. Has that made that difficult?
Yes. yeah, it has.
Is that the reason for the hoodie? You can pull that over and no one can see you?
Yeah, pretty much. Yes. No, yeah, I mean, I think the main reason it's so hard is like you're supposed to do dumb things and then learn from them. And being famous while you're doing that is really hard because the internet forgets that they all did it too when they were that young. And it's just really hard to grow up when the world is like tearing everything about you apart, you know? It's really hard. So I really will never forgive social media for tearing down teenagers, ever. Ever.
I'm sure there's lots of teenagers who are listening to this at the moment and wondering how you cope with that.
Yeah. I mean, I wonder. I literally wonder. I don't know how. It's hard. And I kind of wish it wasn't my life. But I do love making art, and I love doing shows and touring and having the sweet baby fans to enjoy it all with, and that has held up in making it worth it, and I hope that it stays more good than bad.
I'm taking you home. You're coming home with me.
You have been particularly strong when it comes to calling out the sexualization of young women. Why has that been such an important subject for you to tackle?
People think that sexualizing someone means anything that has to do with them looking good or like feeling good, and it's really annoying to me because a lot of people, a lot of men especially, go like, well, you say you don't want to be sexualized and then you wear something that's sexy, and it's like, yeah. that's it. What are you at? Like, what's your question? It's for me. I think that it's just important that people remember that we want to be what we want to be. We don't want your opinion of what we are, so we can sexualize ourselves all we want. We just don't want you to.
Billie credits her strong convictions to the support of her parents and her equally talented brother, Phineas.
The moment that I like realized how amazing it is and how important it's been is when I've talked to other artists or just people in the spotlight that, you know, came up young or just didn't have a good family supporting them, and just heard people's stories, and I'm just like, oh my God, like I don't even know how lucky I am to have a family that loves me and supports me and is here with me, because I really don't know how I would do this otherwise. I really don't. I've thought about it so much lately.
You've done so much, Billie, at such a young age. What do you still dream of doing?
I have a lot of dreams of doing stuff. There's a lot of, you know, like life goals I have and like bucket list things I have that I have my own list, and I think about it, and I don't really talk about it because it's all just like little things that I want to just accomplish without telling anyone or anybody having any knowledge of it, you know? I think we all have like inner goals that we want that maybe we just don't want to say, and like they'll just happen, hopefully. I don't know. I have a lot.
Billie, it's been an absolute pleasure to chat to you, and congratulations on the new album, as I said. We hope one day we can see you down here in Oz.
Oh my God, I can't wait for the day. I will be there, don't worry. But it's great talking to you too, and thanks for having me.
What an absolute legend.
Isn't she?
It's incredible at 19 for someone to have such composure, yeah, and such creativity and be such a tour de force, especially when I look back and think of myself at that age. But also, I think about all the negative news and stuff going around, and people, yeah, being worried about COVID and literally the state of the world, combined with people saying, oh, young people just don't get it these days. And then you see someone like Billie Eilish and you're like, yeah, we're going to be fine.
Yeah. Do you know what that felt like? It sort of felt like you were just talking to a friend on Zoom. Like, she's just sitting there in front of a curtain, in a jumper, yeah, just, you know, shooting the breeze, and talking very casually.
And it at 19, yeah, she's so thoughtful, mm, and really cares about her fans, as we saw in that footage there. You know, her fans mean a lot to her. Mm. And she's still pumping out the most incredible music.